Hey, Charles, you want a cigar?
No, now leave me alone. Nothing like listening to local radio to remind me that I'm a broke, out-of-work actor who can't afford satellite radio.
People all over the globe listen.
EMM Radio 81.5, The Cow.
Come with us.
Oof, I almost hit that kid. Are you okay?
You almost hit me.
I apologize. My car got impounded. So I'm borrowing my friend Wario's. It doesn't handle so well. I apologize for almost hitting you back there. Let me take you home and we'll pretend like it never happened.
No wonder your old car got impounded. You're such a bad driver.
Respect your elders or I'm going to kick you out of this car right now.
This isn't my house.
I know. We're just stopping by my house real quick because I bought ice cream from the Piggy Mart. I don't want it to melt in my trunk. I'm back and I brought ice cream. Now we can continue our ice cream social like scheduled.
Oh, that's wonderful. Who's this?
Oh, well, you see, on the way
you
back,
hit this car. Charles?
No, it was a near miss. She dodged out of the way before I hit her. And it wasn't with my car, it was with Wario's car, because mine is impounded.
You need to be more careful. What if you did hit her? You could have gotten a lawsuit on your hands.
But I didn't. She's just making a big deal about this because I decided to drop the ice cream off before I took her home.
Oh, well, this is kind of quaint.
Ow!
Ah! Who are you?
I live here. I should be asking you that question.
I'm Serena. The mustache guy hit me with his car.
He better not have hit you. I cannot have another accident on my insurance.
Anyways, what are you even doing in there?
What are you talking about?
I mean in there. What are you doing in the mirror?
Wow! I fell into the toilet, and now I'm in bathroom world. Go get Charles. He'll know what to do.
Okay.
Hurry, or else the poop will eat me.
What are you doing?
I'm doing a bit of investigating. I'm convinced there's a demon in here when it's my lights off. And he disappears when I turn it back on. I'm trying to learn how he does it.
There's a fat guy inside the mirror in the bathroom?
Well, no, he's in bathroom world.
I'm not saying you're a bad driver. I'm just saying that you could stand to be a little more careful when you drive.
Normally, I'm a careful driver. I'm just not used to driving Wario's car. It handles quite poorly. Guys, I need help. Wario is...
Good, no, Johnny. This is important.
Are you ever going to take me home?
I'm having an important conversation. Please don't chime in. Look, I'm not mad. I'm just having an off day. I just want this ice cream social to go well.
History Channel now returns to its documentary about what happened to all the Nazi scientists.
Who is this man seen photographed with Adolf Hitler right here?
We have combed through all the records of what happened to the Nazi scientists. We found nothing on this man. So to this day, he remains a mystery.
Jeez, they watch this garbage?
I'm gonna need your help.
Oh, I can't because...
Oh, dang it. You're no good to me.
The blonde guy just drove off in the car?
Take it, he's not supposed to drive since he got his license suspended. I have to find him before he inevitably gets arrested for sexual harassment. Then it's revealed he doesn't have a license. He gets charged for not having one while driving, too.
I'm coming with you. Wait for me!
I can't think of Johnny driving to anywhere that isn't in the city, but did he say where he was going to before he drove off?
I don't know. He probably wanted something toilet-related, if I had to guess.
Why would he want something toilet-related?
I don't know. He said something about saving a fat guy from Bathroom World earlier.
Wait a second. Save him from what?
In the bathroom, there was a fat guy in the mirror, and the Johnny was trying to... I think he's going to go save him somehow.
Why didn't you tell me Wario was in Bathroom World?
Well, I told Johnny, and he seemed like he had everything under control.
Johnny cannot be trusted with important tasks.
I'm sorry, I didn't know.
Great. It's too late to hurry back now. The poop has probably already eaten him.
Look, I don't know what Bathroom World is, but I'm positive Wario is okay.
You're a mighty fine human.
Rosa, this is Charles. Wario is in Bathroom World, and I fear we may never see him again.
I'll save you, Wario.
Well, at the very least, we can go find Johnny.
Where will we find him anyways?
I have an idea. I was told you'd save Wario from Bathroom World, and then I just find you at one of these Skinamax theaters.
Well, Charlemagne, what can I say? Got distracted.
You're disgusting for watching that kind of stuff.
Charlemagne, I'm sorry. What if Rosa were here? She'd tell you to lighten the mood with some radio.
But Rosa isn't here. She's went off to try and save Wario from Bathroom World. Against my warnings!
You know, Johnny, you're really making my blood come to a boil right now. Wait a half of my day.
Oh. Are you okay?
I'm having a heart attack.
Call an ambulance.
I don't think we can. The ambulance blew up.
Come on. Let's drive him to the hospital.
We can't. My license was suspended a few months ago. I shouldn't be driving.
There's a good chance this man is dead. And if there's any small chance we can save his life by getting him to a hospital, I want to take it. You'd seriously drive without a license to watch a dirty movie without to save your own friend's life? That's horrible. I'm getting into a hospital whether you help me or not, so you might as well help me. I gotta tell him when he wakes up that you're just gonna let him die.
Don't you mean if he wakes up? I haven't seen a lot of people survive a death star beam.
Just quit with your pessimism and drive. You all should be very lucky that he's still alive. He took quite a beating.
That's because the Grim Reaper is afraid of me.
Well, a few weeks ago, you missed your doctor's appointment. And now you have stick-it-to-demoniosis.
What? That's impossible. That's just something Jack Black came up with in School of Rock.
No, it's very real, and you're probably gonna die. I'd estimate you at maybe a few weeks left to live, at most, if you're lucky.
That's impossible. I mean, the Grim Reaper is afraid of me. He's not going to come and claim my soul.
I don't know how the Grim Reaper operates, but I'm just doing my job as a medical professional to tell you you're probably going to die.
Would you quit being so pessimistic? This is my life we're talking about here.
Well, there's a chance it may not be terminal, but your odds of getting through this just aren't very good. You're just going to have to face them. Just get plenty of rest and hope you get better, I guess.
I will not rest. I have the strength of a wieldy magnum, and I will not be kept down. I'm saving you two from Bathroom World one way or another, even if it kills me.
Charter, man? Are you sure this is okay? We both know how dangerous it is down there.
Jody, if anybody could handle the perils of Bathroom World, I know it is me.
I'm your only man!
Wow, that was intense. Thank you for saving me. I was almost human stool.
No, Rosa and Wario, you've missed quite a lot, but I got banged up pretty bad out. No, I miraculously escaped unscathed, but Nurse Joy diagnosed me with stickatudamoniosis, and I may not have much time left.
You have that. It's pretty serious, Charles. You should be resting.
No, I came to terms with this during my time in Bathroom World, and I realized I may not even have a future. I'm an old man, after all. And if this is true, then I don't want to have any regrets when I die. Will you all help me do everything on my bucket list?
Sure,
Charlemagne. All right, then. Let's get started.
Now, why on earth would I let you two knuckleheads win a Ferrari? Because my best friend is dying and he wants to do this. How would that supposed to convince me?
We're trying to appeal to your good-natured side.
I'm a car salesman. I don't have a good-natured side or a conscience.
Okay, how about we shoot you and take the car instead?
Whoa, now. Okay, fine. Just have it back in an hour. We are so in there. Dang, we crashed into this trash can.
Who cares? All that matters is that I got to drive a Ferrari. Now that's one thing off my bucket list. Well, we rented a Ferrari, and then we crashed it. So that's one thing off my bucket list.
I was going through your stuff, and I found out you're still married. I didn't know you had a wife.
No, I don't want to talk about that right now.
But maybe talking about it will make you feel better.
Okay, fine. After my second wife, Jew Ireland, passed away, this woman, Kim Week, started doing most of her jobs that she took on when she was alive. Eventually, it got to a point where she said she's not going to help me anymore unless I marry her. So, I did what I had to for the sake of my family.
Well, maybe you could reconcile with her or something.
No, I never want to see her again. I want to make that very clear. Let's just move on with my bucket list already. I still can't believe I've never tried Chinese food.
Oh man, you're going to be in for a real treat.
Why did I want to eat this? This didn't agree with my stomach at all. Are you okay in there, Wario? Why is it every time I go to the bathroom with you, it sounds like you're firing off cannons into the toilet?
The only other time that you've been in the bathroom with me recently is, when we went on vacation not that long ago. Just let me do this in peace.
You're not the only one suffering, but you're making so much noise. It sounds like a college humor sketch in there.
You didn't need as much as I did.
I don't know what I walked in on, but I'm pretty sure I'm too young to even begin to want to know just what's happening here.
Serena, you shouldn't. You shouldn't be in here. This is the men's room.
Actually, you guys went to the family bathroom, and the couple outside the fridge take their toddler in here because of all the noises coming from here.
We'll take as long as we need to.
Serena, just
Wait at the table.
Mom, not waiting at the table. I saw a roach on it.
Dang it. Ugh. And the review said this was the only Chinese restaurant in town to be roach-free. Ooh, the key to Wario's car is on the table. Just take it, and you can listen to EMM Radio 81.5 to come while you wait.
I don't know if I necessarily trust that. It sounds like you guys might be in there a while.
We're into having a bell blowout right now.
Well, my mom orders Chinese food all the time. I'm used to this kind of food.
Ooh. Oy. Oh, look at you.
All right, let's see what's on EMM Radio.
You're listening to EMM Radio 81.5, The Cub.
Hey, this is fine. Why don't I go play something on my Game Boy? Man, these GBA shooters are awesome.
You should try playing Wario Land 4.
Hey, why is Charles in the back seat?
Things got so difficult he passed out. He's not used to this kind of a blowout like I am.
Strange, considering he's the old man. I figure he'd be the one with incontinence.
I don't have incontinence. It has a very sensitive stomach.
Yeah, whatever.
I really wanted the knock-knock ditch for some time, but when I was at the appropriate age, I lived in a really poor mining town, and there wasn't really many houses I could knock-knock ditch.
I don't know, Charles. This seems kind of mean. What do we do if we get caught?
Well, Rosa, you better hope you can run fast enough.
Johnny, that's not going to reassure her. Look, Rosa, my friends Shauna and Caleb from my old town before I moved do this all the time. All we ever got was a slap on the wrist.
That's a knock already!
All right, let's see his reaction.
Man, what are the odds of...
I don't want to talk about it.
What's that scary thing we ran from?
I said I don't want to talk about it, okay? Let's just drop the subject.
Okay, well, Charles, I'm sorry, but... It looks like you've done all the reasonable things on your bucket list.
No, there's plenty of things left to do. Like rob a bank, shake James Gardner's hand, or go to Iran.
Well, we don't want to go to jail, so... Well, I can't help you rob a bank. James Gardner is long dead. And I'm pretty sure if we went to Iran, we'd be dead too. I'll go see who it is. It's Nurse Joy. I come with good news. You are perfectly healthy. Or at least as healthy as a man your age can be.
What about you telling me all that stuff about having to face the music and that I might not live much longer?
Well, since you skipped your appointment, I kind of mixed up your file with someone else's, and so someone else actually has it.
So I'm going to live?
For the foreseeable future.
What a relief. I hate to admit it, but I don't think I could live my life without you.
Same here, Charlaman.
I'm real glad to have not lost you within days of meeting you. I'm so happy you're okay.
Oh, thanks, guys. But wait. If I'm okay, what about the man who does have stickatudomoniosis?
I should probably tell him.
Well, that's right. The doctor gave me a clean bill of health. Oh, I'm suddenly feeling very, very sick. Why do I stay up right long? Oh.
No way. I just hope I'm not too late.